Think DIY SOS, but on a slightly smaller scale. It started earlier this year as an idea on paper, but soon became something much bigger, changing the lives of those involved.
I managed to break my arm, so I couldn't work and I couldn't pay for my rent. And landlady kicked me out to the streets. I was feeling like a bad dream, and everything what happened to me was a nightmare.
And what's it like to live here?
Oh, it's amazing. I feel good, I feel better. I feel alive, I feel happy.
It costs between £5,000 and £10,000, takes 5 days and around 20 volunteers to kit out a single container.
We've helped out a lot. They're really appreciative of everything we've done, even just tiny things like putting the taps in. We've come here after work to put in a tap and stuff like that. Goes a long way.
It was the brainchild of local businessman Jasper Thompson, who wanted to do something more to help.
I started just like everyone else do, go out and do hand out sandwiches and bedding, clothing and stuff like that. And February time, when the weather was really bad, we took the guys off the streets, housed them, just to keep them dry and warm for a few days and stuff.
The plan is to convert 12 of these shipping containers, 10 as living accommodation and another 2 as a restaurant and laundrette. They'll then all be moved to a private site where they'll become a gated community.
So far, around 30 homeless people have been given shelter here over the past 6 months. The project has been so successful, it's now being seen as a blueprint for other schemes across the country.
We've got a group in Hull who wants to do the same thing, Plymouth. We even got an email from Wrexham. Wrexham's really want to get on board.
It's hoped this container will be converted into a house by Friday, giving someone else a new hope for the future.
I never lost the faith, just a matter of time. And next week I'm going to be working in a charity shop. So I've got a job.
Natasha Turney, BBC Points West, Bristol.